All right, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to unveil that secret project that I've been talking about in the community tabs, which is this huge, massive project that I've been working on, a site that will go over just about anything a home user could think of when it comes to cybersecurity. A couple of things that I want to mention before we start diving in here and I go through some of the stuff that's on here. First of all, the website is a work in progress. I've got this banner up here saying that this is the initial launch of the website. I'd been hauling ass the last couple of weekends, basically spending all my free time trying to get this thing set up. I ran into a lot of issues. It's a bespoke website, so it took a lot of time for me to get all of this stuff set up properly. I didn't want to go with something like Squarespace or Wix and just have some crappy looking template garbage. So I took the time to design something that was proper. Second of all, I'm sure you're wondering, what in the hell is up with your color palette on this website? For those who don't know, I don't think I've ever actually mentioned this on the channel before. I'm a big fan of something called synthwave music. And in a lot of these synthwave videos that you can find on YouTube that have like this synthwave music, it's pretty good. I listen to it a lot in the background. I'll just be doing work or whatever, and then I'll just play it in the background so I can listen to something that doesn't have lyrics and it has like a nice beat and everything. They use like a lot of the similar color palette with like a lot of dark colors, a lot of like orange, purple, like this pink color kind of thing. You could scroll through a lot of these videos here and kind of see like, you know, like here you have like a lot of black colors, pink, all that kind of stuff. That's kind of like the synthwave color palette. I think it looks pretty good. I didn't want to go with a light theme website. I may see if I can add like a light theme, dark theme toggle at some point. That's going to be a lot of work to try to get that done, so it's not on my list of priorities right now. But yeah, so that's where the color scheme is coming into play. And you can't see it here because of how I've got OBS set up, but down here at the bottom, past where my mouse cursor is going, you can see there's links to the change log. So whenever I change something on the website, I will post that onto the changelog. So I've only got this initial one here for the initial launch of the website. I will add, as like I add more pages and stuff, or if I update content, I'll put in here what it is that I'm changing. That way, like when you come back to the website to like get an update, see what's changed and all that kind of stuff, you just have to click into the changelog to see what I've been up to with this website. Now, let's get into the good stuff. One other thing real quick. There is a homepage on here. This is just a placeholder right now. I mean, just you can just basically ignore this. There's really nothing of significance with this. When you come here, basically just click on cybersecurity. I'll put a link down below. It's kenharris.io is the website. So let's go through. I'll just kind of give you a quick quick guide as to what I have going on with this thing. So right now I only have the Windows 10/11 hardening guide and the OPSEC guide done. Network security is going to be the next one. And then after that, it will probably be the Linux hardening guide and then probably hardware software considerations. I'm saving Mac OS and the iOS guides for last just because Apple's stuff is really secure as is, and there's really very little that you even need to do to it anyway. So I didn't figure there was any point in rushing to get this one done. So I've got a ton of information on here. Like I said, I spent the last couple of weekends, been working on this off and on for a while. I just spent the last couple weekends hauling ass on this because I was like, you know, I got to get this done, get the initial version out so I can start getting some feedback, see how people like it, see what changes need to be made, and then I can add to it as time goes on. So your Windows hardening guide and your OPSEC guide, I mean, those are really good starting points, and these aren't even done. And like, just to give you an idea of how much I had done to this, I have, I think it's almost 50 pages. I'd been making Word docs for like each separate section that I was making. And if you combine everything together, the total came out to like almost 50 pages. And like I said, these aren't even fully fleshed out yet. So by the time this whole website is done, there's probably gonna be like 200 to 300 pages of stuff for like home users when it comes to like cybersecurity, because especially like when I get into network security, it's gonna be really detailed. There's gonna be things like DNS, encrypted DNS, filtering, firewalls, routers, OpenSense, PFSense, all that kind of stuff. I'll have build guides in there. I'll have security guides. I'll have best practices, all that stuff set up. So let's jump into it because this video's gonna end up really dragging on here. So let's start with the Windows hardening guide first. I was trying to think of a way, so I think there's like 30 to 35 pages of content here, like if you put it out on a Word doc and pasted it. And I couldn't like really find a better way for this website than to just have like these tabs that you can click on. And so this is basically what I've gone with. It took a ton of work to get this done. Like it took more time to do the website than it did for me to get all of the content for the website up to this point. So I wasn't gonna get super lost in the sauce as to how I was going to build out the website. I think that it looks pretty good and I think it flows pretty good. If you're curious, you can come to Google PageSpeed Insights. The performance, I'm gonna try to get this up to like mid 90s. Accessibility got 100 score, best practices got 100 score. When I finish SEO, that's probably gonna be 100. I used to be a web developer in the past and I wanted that to show, like I've been putting a shitload of work. I'm not kidding you guys when I say that I'm bringing like the best quality content, not only video, but what I have on this website, it's the absolute best quality that I can put out, or it's going to be. Like this is still a work in progress, so it's not done yet. But I mean, if you go run this on a lot of websites aren't anywhere near these scores. Like I want this website to run well. I want it to look good. I want it to be functional. I want it to be accessible. I want it to have like good SEO, all that stuff. And so I want this stuff to reflect that. But anyway, let's get back to this. So I'll go through the Windows hardening guide real quick. Just some highlights. We're not gonna go into all the content. You can go read that on your own if you want to. So intro, I've got a legal disclaimer here. Make sure you read this. If you break your shit, I'm not legally liable for it. Read and understand this. The thing is, when it comes to security, and I've mentioned this here in the disclaimer, the more you try to increase security, privacy, and or anonymity, the more hassle you have to go through to get your computer to work right. So if you don't want to deal with more hassle, then basically like 99% of this stuff probably isn't even gonna apply to you. If you wanna turn on things like BitLocker, you hard Windows Defender, you want to use a better firewall, turn on Secure Boot, all that kind of stuff, like it's going to add hassle to things. So just keep that in mind. And I put a lot of really important content in here. I put a lot of context in here on each of these pages. You know, I've got things like, you know, right now, Windows 11, with the 23 H2 update that's coming, a lot of it's gonna be written in Rust. There's like 30,000 lines of code, and then by Windows 12, probably the whole thing's gonna be turned over to Rust. Things like that help give context to people as to, like, everything that's going on with Windows, like the vulnerabilities it has now versus here in the future, like with Windows 12, it should be way more secure, all that kind of stuff. Then I start going through specific things. So, and this isn't even finished yet. There's like 5 or 6 pages worth of Word document content here. I'm not even done with this. I'm still building this stuff out. But I go through, again, context. I go through and put down everything that you should be doing. I have these warnings here. Make sure you pay attention to the warnings because if you don't, you could break something, or like these give you really important context as to actions that I suggest. So make sure you look at the warnings and understand these. And then I break down all the different sections. So like account protection, firewall, network protection, like this is, I put a lot of detail into this stuff. And then I've got all these other tabs here, drivers and software, secure boot and TPM, how to turn them on, what they do. I've got info on firewalls. This isn't done yet because I'm gonna be adding videos and pictures into here to help guide people. Basically, I'm writing this stuff like someone's coming into this not knowing everything. Like they would need to have a good grasp of computers, but they don't need to be experts. So I've got that. As you can see here, like I embedded my BitLocker tutorial video on this page here, but I still have a ton of pictures put up. Telemetry. hardening tools, that one's coming soon. I've got extra steps. I'll be adding on to these as time goes on. So a lot of stuff, a lot of content. And then the OPSEC guide, if you don't want to do anything like hardening your computer, like if you don't want to deal with the hassle that that's going to add, then what you could do, this is really useful stuff. Come over here to the OPSEC guide. Again, I have an intro here of what is on the page, what this stuff is about. And then I go through each specific thing. So security, privacy, and anonymity, the difference between them. And then, like I said, this is gonna be fleshed out even more. Like this, I just needed to get this released now so we could start getting some feedback, start getting some visitors to this, to the website and all that kind of stuff. Got social media stuff, telemetry and data collection, encryption. And then I've got physical access here, which is going to be way more expanded at some point in the future. Social engineering, this one's gonna be expanded on a lot. Threat landscape, this is gonna be a pretty long one. That's why I have coming soon. This one's gonna take me a while to build all of this stuff out. And then a section on nation state actors. This is a hot take that's probably gonna really get some people worked up. If it does, then oh well, whatever. So as the weeks and months progress, I would like to have basically this whole thing at least pretty much done by like November. I was looking at end of October or first part of October just to launch this, but I thought to hell with it, I'm just gonna get it done now. I'm thinking by like mid to late November, I should have all of this stuff filled out. I'm trying to do this in between all of the work that I'm doing. So, you know, I've still got all the work that I do. I've got all the content that I'm still trying to post, and then I've got this. So it's just a matter of me getting enough time to be able to finish this stuff up. So a lot of info. If there's anything in particular you would like me to cover, make sure you go ahead and drop a comment. Let me know if things aren't working on the website. One other thing I'll mention real quick, the mobile version of the website, I've not optimized for yet. So if you try and view mobile in the landscape form, it should work pretty decent. Tablets, it should work fine. If you try to do the portrait view on a cell phone, I don't think this website's really gonna work all that well. Like I said, it's just, I've gotta set my priorities straight for the time being. And in order for me to properly set up the website for mobile, I would basically need to have a lot of the website pretty much already done. So I'm not going to optimize for mobile for a little bit yet. Like I said, if you use it landscape, it should work fine, but portrait, I don't think it's gonna work all that well. You'll see like a lot of this stuff will be smushed or not fully loading on screen. And there's so much content on this website anyway, I think it would be a pain in the ass to even try to use it on a cell phone. So like I said, that kind of wraps this up. Make sure you let me know what your suggestions and comments and all that kind of stuff are down below. Let me know. Keep an eye on the change log. I'm going to be adding a ton of stuff as time goes on. And I also want to thank everyone for your support. August, I've already seen a ton of growth. I'm getting a lot more engagement on the channel. Things are growing. Things are looking really good. Building out a solid community here. And I plan to keep that going. Linux content, the first piece of Linux content should be dropping before the end of this month. I was gonna try and have the OpenSense and pfSense videos done before the end of the month, but this kind of derailed that a little bit, so those are gonna end up getting moved to next month at this point. If you want more info, I will drop a community post update kind of outlining some more stuff, like more details coming about the website and all that kind of stuff and content updates and all of that. And with all that said, that's going to wrap the video up for good this time. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on Friday.